Welcome to It's Your Date with Destiny with Apostle Vivian and Pastor Gemma Duncan of Divine Destiny Worship Center in Diego Martin. For the next 30 minutes, join us as we take you on a journey of maximizing your potential and realizing your goals through Jesus Christ. Whether it's on a Sunday, Tuesday, or Friday, or any other day of the week, a warm welcome awaits you at Divine Destiny Worship Center, a place where your full potential is discovered. Here's a special invitation to join us at our sanctuary.
We give God the praise just for being alive. We give God the praise for being saved. We give God the praise for being sane. Because for what has been happening in our nation, I mean, we are talking about that which was sacred years ago now has become commonplace. What do I speak in respect of? In respect of relationships. It was husband and wife, or even if it was a man and a woman. Now, by law, the judge has swept aside what was in the books for years to protect our nation from deteriorating into another Sodom and Gomorrah. And as I speak this without any kind of apologies, because as I've been saying, even if you don't believe God made man, and you believe nature caused man to evolve, well, then nature is a very smart, wise, powerful agent. Because nature has made the male body the way it is, and the female body the way it is, so that both could complement each other. So if it's just nature. But I'm saying to those who are prayer warriors, do not hang your head. Do not feel defeated. Why? Because when Jesus was here, there was homosexuality. Abraham was here, there was homosexuality. When Paul was here, there was homosexuality. And he wrote very powerfully in it. He says, those who think they are wise, they turn out to be fools. So, let God be God. Amen. Go read Romans chapter 1. And you will realize I've taken up the same mantra like Apostle Paul. Verse 16, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for it's the power of God unto salvation. And anybody who tries to twist that truth is guilty of witchcraft. Because witchcraft is about manipulation of the mind, making the mind accept that which is unseemly. Amen. And I speak your deliverance right now. In fact, I'm going to anoint my hand right now. And maybe there's somebody looking at me who has been sucked into that type of behavior and mentality. And today, I speak your deliverance. And when you get delivered, come, let's pour some more oil on you. Bring your relatives and bring all those who have been hanging with you in that kind of a suspended animation, because it's not a reality. It's part of Satan's plan to control this world by controlling the minds of people. Destiny anointing oil. Every time we come on the set, we anoint our hands with it. And today specifically, I'm speaking to the LBGTQIAP. Society. So if you're one of them, I'm releasing a powerful anointing right now to break that demonic influence. It's demonic possession. It's demonic oppression, obsession, just whatever you want to call it. But the Spirit of the Lord of God is upon me, for he has anointed me, like Jesus said, to set captives free. And I repent that spirit right now, and I release the Spirit of God to break the chains. Why not call us at 633-3780 during the week? Or better than that, come visit us at Divine Destiny Worship Center this Sunday morning. We are down at our largest facility called Calvary Revival Center, right down there, 100 Southern Main Road, Edinburgh Village in Chaguanas. All our branches, besides those that are overseas, will be gathering there. We really want you to come. When you go down the highway, you see the big building there. Well, you can access us from the main road. Amen. I really believe somebody got their healing today. So good morning. I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan on behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the Covenanters of Divine Destiny Worship Center, the House of Champions, welcoming you to It's Your Date with Destiny, the television arm of our media ministry. Well, we've been having a time and three quarter plus a half at Divine Destiny Worship Center on these weekends, because we've been going after the whole series the Lord gave us on moving from sores to soaring. And we've been into a dimension of the agents of sores for the last 2 months and some more, where we've been dealing with breaking the powers of witchcraft, because we have found out that most of the people who are hurting is somebody who has inflicted pain on them because they want to manipulate and control the mind. But we have seen deliverance after deliverance after deliverance. People who are coming into their own because they are now understanding that when God made us, He made us with purpose, He made us with destiny, and He made us so that we can actually dovetail our spirits into His spirit. Amen. So we're taking you today again through an excerpt of one of the, I have to call it an episode, one of the episodes of deliverance that came by way of the teaching, breaking the powers of witchcraft, and the type of impact that it had on people as they answered the altar call. Amen. So make sure you call up somebody and tell them, hey, you could get your freedom today. Amen.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Woo! To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power.
Come on. Parents who use the accusation of neglect and abandonment to put a child on a guilt trip concerning studies abroad or even getting married are guilty of the same practice. All similar scenarios come under the same cloud of darkness. Those who are so inclined must know that they run the risk of coming into a head-on collision with the Holy God, who hates witchcraft. Galatians 5:20 includes it as a work of the flesh. In Micah 5:12, the prophet Micah shows God's disgust with it when he writes, "And I will cut off witchcrafts out of thine hand, and thou shalt have no more soothsayers." Oh, later on when we show the PowerPoint sometime to come, you will see how many synonyms there are to the word witchcraft and the word witch. The prime mover in all of this is the spirit of unforgiveness. People who have not yet dealt with the pains of rejection whether during childhood or in their adult life, usually adopt the policy that no one will ever get the chance to do that to me again as long as they live. Consequently, when they come into positions of power, they seize the opportunity to protect themselves by creating power zones around themselves. From the relative safety of these zones, they can project a larger than life picture in order to keep potential abusers at bay. For them, if you have not forgiven anybody who looks like your mother, looks like your father or your stepfather or your pastor, it doesn't matter, whoever it was that inflicted initial pain on you, and not just initial pain, but kept making it more and more excruciating, have actually caused you to develop a frame in your vision where you fit everybody else that's coming towards you into that. And anybody that fits there smugly or almost fit, that person will get the same venom you feel for the father or mother or pastor or whoever was in authority over you that inflicted that initial pain on you. And that's why so many young men, oh, we're going to come to that. I'll show you that gangsterism began in heaven. Under the same spirit that pushes and energizes witchcraft. That's why gangsterism is about jealousy. Gangsterism is about territorial control, territorial spirits. Gangsterism is about murder because of your inability to handle the fact that your rival is alive. You institute murder. You take young men and distort their minds, manipulate their anger into an energy to bring pain. That's why, oh my God, I'm teaching you some stuff. That's why soon I'll get back to DDPT and start to teach on another level of warfare. We have to start this warfare not from the depths of hell, it's from heaven. Because God, wherever God is, He's the Most High. Wherever God is, He's El Elyon. And one of the things that pushes people into witchcraft is also pride. Selfishness. This is for me. And if I find what is for me, you are occupying it, I'm going to walk away to get you out of there. Or at least to get myself on top of you. To dictate how you flow. That even if you accomplish something, the reflection is on me. If it wasn't for me, you couldn't get it. That's witchcraft. But we're going to go deeper into it as we journey. Let me read this. Consequently, when such people come into positions of power, they seize the opportunity to protect themselves by creating power zones around them. In executing this plan, many such people, so affected, unwittingly, but most of them deliberately, attempt to exact revenge for previous hurts. Not necessarily upon those who hurt them, but on any other human being who comes too close. Why should it can't be fair? I come in your life, I never hurt you. I come in your life to do good, and I've been doing good since I came in your life. But somebody before you met me did you bad. But because you can't get to them, you're doing it to me? It means that you have hexed yourself. You have had so much pain, you can't even think straight. Because the one person who has come to neutralize your pain You're pouring out your venom on me. And that is why in church we get more deep hurts than when we were out there. Because when we come into church, we don't expect anybody to be operating under revenge or vengeful spirit. We don't expect anybody sitting next to us, dancing with us by the altar, worshiping, helping us cast out devils, to have that kind of poisonous, venomous spirit. So I came into church and I checked in my weapons out by the gate. Them car park fellas have my weapons. And I come up inside here to worship my God with you. But I didn't realize that you didn't check in yours. Them weapons of jealousy, covetousness. How come pastor could call them? How pastor could use them? Oh, look at them. So I know so much about them. And pastor supposed to be a prophet. Oh, yeah, I know them thing about them. Pastor, mine, they among the thing in my mind. I draw space for that. And even if God tell me, I'll call them to counsel them. I would not do like you, sit down and send venom at them. Let she make a mistake when she preaching. Let him make a mistake when he preaching. And let him look stupid. That is hexing. That is obia. Hey, in the midst of big spotlights like what we have, boy. And television lights. You could do the occult. The real occult practitioners, they have a dark room. But there are those who could do it in bright daylight. Because the real nexus of the obia is in your mind and your brain. If you can't handle somebody else's success, then you are actually preparing to hex them. And I'm animated about this because too many young people who had potential to succeed, some of them right in church, somebody licked them down. But listen, not under the watch of Emmanuel and Vivian and Gemma Duncan, Gemma Patricia Duncan, not under our watch, because we intend to expose the spirit of witchcraft. Arm you up. While I'm exposing it, she's teaching you how to arm yourself. Yeah. Prepare yourself. Somebody said, thank you, Jesus. The Bible says, do not be ignorant of the devil's devices. In pursuit of this, they seem to get great enjoyment from seeing others squirm under their authority. However, to their own shame, they soon come to the stark reality that power based on fear can never bring complete satisfaction. That explains why such people are always so frustrated and dissatisfied, even though they have countless others bowing at their feet and answering their beck and call. They have to constantly invent new devices of control so as to stay in power. We thank God that this nation has an army. Oh no, not the regiment, an army of intercessors. An army of watchmen, my God, who will stand and bring
you. Good. Well, we give God the praise that you allowed us into your space today with this heavy word from the very beginning into the preached word. But we want you to know, if you set yourself to serve God, He gives you the power to withstand the pressures that come. Amen. And our men, anointed men, able men of and we say, royal destiny. We are going to be having our conference in the month of October, and we want you to be there. Take a look at the clip right now that's going to stimulate your pure minds to be part of this conference. And we are having it in honor of our fallen soldier, Elder Elmo Russo, going for gold.
I called him daddy, and he called me son. But he never taught me the consequences for holding a gun. This macho man I once believed was the man I was destined to be. Not knowing in his heart, he wanted no part. Determined to drop mommy and I like a bad habit. Responsibilities, he just won't have it. Too young to discern, I grew with the intent he would make his way through the door. Years passed by, suddenly we're now at four. As the months multiplied, I wondered when Houdini would reappear. Time returned no one, and before I knew, I was placed in the arena to fight a battle for which I was unprepared. And as the blows rained down, I was at the mercy of life's hand. As I emerged, life striked with more vengeance, and I asked, Daddy, where are you? You weren't around to teach me how to cook, but a man came along, and not that of the Vatican, because in him I had no hope. But Jesus was this man that took me out of that sinking sand. He showed me what he was about, and in him I had no doubt. Truly, he was the one.
I am an able man of royal destiny.
I am an able man of royal destiny.
I am an able man of royal destiny.
I am lovable.
I am teachable.
And dependable.
Amen. You need to be calling our office this week, registering your name, and being here from the 18th of October, that's a Thursday, the 19th and the 20th. It's going to be awesome. Able men of royal destiny. Amen. And we want to take you to our testimony corner. Oh, we've been having so many testimonies of people getting their freedom, their deliverance, and whatever else you want to label it as. So just enjoy this testimony.
I've been coming to church here since 2004. And, I grew up in a Hindu home, and every Christmas, my uncles will, they will say, well, take a little drink for, the stomach and things. So every Christmas, we drinking, me, like a man with a chaser, straight, right? My husband, every time we be coming home, he'll pass on by, he will ask what I want. I say, buy a shandy now. So I find I'm putting on weight because it's every day. So I tell him, I will stop that. Don't bother to buy nothing for me. So I stop it. I stopped drinking wine and, stopped thinking about it. And afterwards, coming to church here and praying, I know I have been delivered from that. Because, since I stopped drinking shandy, there was a day that I felt so, clean and holy and pure before God. You no longer desire for the alcohol and the spirits. And Apostle has been preaching on that. And some of us, we still go and buy it and, sipping saints. So I thank God for deliverance that I don't have the desire to even drink a shandy, So I give God praise and thanks for that.
Amen. Good. And we also wanted to know that every Monday night that we would announce, we are having a workshop on deliverance. We want to teach people, equip everyone who is a soldier of the cross, everyone who is a kingdom citizen, with the wherewithal to what? To discern demons when they are around. To what? Also, cast them out straight up. That you don't have to wait for the big apostle to come. You don't have to wait for the prophet to come. Because if it's in your space, whether it's on your job, in your home, in your neighborhood, the apostle, the prophets, and so on can't come. You have what it takes. When Jesus sent them out, he told them, go cast out devils. He said, heal the sick. And part of that mandate, we want to teach on a Monday night. So this Monday night coming, we will be having that session. And don't forget, this weekend, this Sunday, we are at Calvary Revival Center, 100 Southern Main Road, Edinburgh Village, Chaguanas. Also, we want you to know that on a given week, we have three services on radio. We have Monday on 98.1 at 9 p.m. It's your date with destiny. And on 107.1, every Tuesday at 9:30 p.m., we have Living the More Abundant Life, sponsored by Bee's Ice Cream. And on a Friday, of course, Ask Pastor Gemma on 98.1 at 3 p.m. Oh, so many people's lives are being touched by our radio programs. We want you to just be part of it. Amen.
Next time on Divine Destiny Worship Center's program, this program, It's Your Date with Destiny. You will hear.
But you understand what witchcraft is. You realize you don't always have to have some juju feather in your head. You don't also always have to have some dog bone hanging out your teeth. You gotta go hunga, hunga, huja, huja. No. Just this mind. Until that is fixed, there will always be a big hole at the bottom of society, where the more you pour in, is the more it leaks out. No other nation got more help than Haiti in 2010, I think it is, when they had the earthquake. Billions of dollars, and the nation remains same. Because it's about this.
So, until we meet again, I'm Apostle Vivian Duncan, on behalf of my wife, Apostle Gemma, and all the covenanters of Divine Destiny Worship Center, the House of Champions, declaring to you, you began life as a winner. Don't live it as a victim or die as a loser. You are a God idea, because when God made you, he had destiny on his mind. See you at Divine Destiny this weekend. God bless you. Amen.
Continue to reach your goals through Jesus Christ. This has been It's Your Date with Destiny, a production of Divine Destiny Media Ministry. Until next time, you began life as a winner. Don't live life as a victim or die as a loser. For when God made you, he had destiny on his mind.